Namaste and good morning. In the extended days of lockdown 4.0 in India, we welcome all of you to the webinar organized by FCM MICE. I'm Nimisha Tiwari with ET Panache Travel and MediaWire.in as part of the Times of India Group. And I'm privileged today to have leaders from different spectrum of industries sharing their perspective on what will be the new normal for the MICE industry. The experts will also emphasize about inroads of virtual events into their industry in the near future. Well, this is just going to be an amazing thing to know what the future truly holds out for all of us. Quickly, I would also let you know the agenda of the webinar today is, which is quite interesting, the first point being impact of COVID-19 and how corporate events, meetings and conferences will shape up post the lockdown. The second point would be, in what ways will corporates and hotels soon begin to plan to do their product launches, sales meet, seminars and events? Will virtual events help the MICE industry bounce back faster during these times? Or will it ever be possible for face-to-face meetings at events and conferences? Will this continue to be the main exponents of the MICE industry? Or will the virtual world make its way steadily and surely? The agenda is fantastic, and I would like to now welcome our expert panelists for the day. I would like to welcome Mr. Anup Taneja. Anup Taneja is the Regional Director, Global Sales India and Subcontinent Marriott Hotels. Anup is a key member of Marriott International's Global Sales Organization and part of the Global Sales Leadership Team in the APEC region. Anup is responsible for providing strategic leadership to Marriott's global sales team in India. Anup has had a very illustrious career. He joined Marriott in 2011 as Director of Global Sales Managing North and East India before taking up his current role in 2017 to lead global sales in India and the subcontinent. Anup holds a hotel management degree and a master's in management, specializing in marketing. Welcome, Anup. Welcome on board.
Thank you, Nimisha.
I would now like to welcome Mr. Manpreet Bindra, brand leader, FCM MICE. Manpreet is the brand leader of FCM MICE, the iconic meetings, intensives, incentives, conferences, and exhibitions international brand of FCM Travel Solutions. An industry veteran with a career spanning of over 20 years in the MICE travel business, Manpreet is responsible for overall business strategies and delivery at FCM MICE. Under his leadership, FCM MICE has successfully planned and executed MICE events for national and multinational corporates and emerging businesses. Prior to FCM Travel Solutions, Manpreet has held several leadership positions in the travel industry, including Carlton Wagenlit Travel. Manpreet also holds management degrees from both Symbiosis Institute of Management Studies and also Indian School of Business. Welcome, Manpreet. Welcome to the panel.
Thank you, Manisha. Thank you.
I would now move on to welcoming our next panelist, Mr. Siddharth Shah. Siddharth is the co-founder and director of WebContext India. Siddharth's digital tech agency, WebContext India, is built around knowledge capital-based services in the domain of digital media, web, and interacting technology. Siddharth has been a person of ideas with more than 10 years of experience in his field, and he holds deep interest in the new age media and its integration with technology. He recently initiated EventBot Solution, an event tech-focused company that aims to solve events with innovative technology solutions. Welcome, Siddharth. How are you? I now welcome Mr. Uthiyo Majumdar, Chief Marketing Officer of Excite Industries Limited. Uthiyo is a well-known name in the field of advertising. After a brief stint at O&M, Uthiyo made JWP his home for 21 years across Chennai and Kolkata offices. He moved to Rediffusion and YNR as Head of Operations for West in August 2015. To prove to himself that he sure can operate outside his comfort zone. He soon switched to the other side in April 2017 by joining Excite Industries Limited to bring a completely different perspective and experience to the iconic Excite brand. Uthiyo loves the thrill of coming up with simple solutions many times at the last hour to the most complicated challenges that the market throws at us. He believes that variety is the spice of life as a baseline for advertising and marketing. Welcome today, dear Rudhya.
Great. Thanks, Nimesha. Looking forward to our exciting session.
Oh, great. Would now like to welcome our panelist, Mr. Prerak Parmar. He is the Chief Distribution Officer at Reliance Nippon Life Insurance. He is armed with 27 years of experience in marketing and distribution, 12 years in FMCG, and over 16 years in BFSI. Having worked with companies like Dabur India Limited, Henkel India, Max and Kotak Group of Companies, Prerak has illustriously handled business worth over 5,000 crores. Welcome, dear Prerak. Welcome today.
Thanks, Nisha. Thank you very much.
Our panelists are all now ready to give us all a profound view of what their industry's future holds out for us and how post-COVID situation shall turn out to be. What can we expect and what do we have to do if we have to live with the present condition of COVID-19? Let me open this discussion by asking Mr. Anup Taneja to tell about the situation with the hospitality sector.
Thanks, Nimesha. First of all, I'd like to thank FCM for organizing this with such a illustrious panel. You know, people from across industries. And it's great to see, you know, the both sides to it, you know, both the supplier and the customer side. So really fortunate to be on the panel and hope as we go along this discussion, you know, looks at some solutions and also looks at what the future looks like so we can all prepare for it. So thank you so much, Manpreet and his team. So, you know, I just want to dwell a bit on the past of what really has happened for us. And I'm sure this is pretty much the same for everyone else in the hotel industry and also in the travel industry. You know, the travel restrictions, social distancing, which has become now more widespread, and obviously it's essentially impacted the entire world. And because of which, you know, we've seen a significant drop in our demands as at the properties. The demand is as low as it went down to almost 90% with us in some of our locations. We've seen some interesting things happening over the last 1.5 months with China coming back into business slowly and steadily. We see that as green shoots in what we are terming it as green shoots in our terminology. We've currently temporarily closed down about 2,000 of our 7,000 hotels globally. But these hotels which have been temporarily shut down are hotels which are going to be ready to open as and when, you know, things start getting better. In spite of the current situation, we remain, you know, very confident of the longer term prospects of our industry. And I can say that, you know, with confidence that things are going to come back sooner than later. The only difference between any other crisis and this one is that this has impacted the whole of the whole world. And obviously the impact is much widespread than it would have been in, with any other crisis that we've actually been through. What we see, and I can say with confidence because we still have new hotels opening happening. We still have new signups happening for hotels. So I think the investors who are investing with us, because we are a management company, they are looking at, you know, this particular industry being a long-term, you know, a industry which is going to be giving a lot of long-term benefits in times to come. So I would say it's a temporary phenomena, and things will get better as we go along. As far as we are concerned, we are doing a lot of work on standards of hygiene and cleanliness, and I'll talk through it as we go through the this discussion on what we are doing as an organization and how we are getting ready for post COVID scenario. What I can say is that currently safety and hygiene has become the new amenity for hotels and for everybody else who's on the call right now. I'll leave it at that, and I'll obviously like to hear from the other panelists as well. And of course, I'm sure we'll be talking a lot more about what everybody else is also doing as we go along in this discussion.
That's a great perspective, Anup. Amazing. I would like to now invite Mr. Uthiyam Majumdar. So what do you think will be the future in the post-COVID days when we begin to learn ways to live with it?
Well, you know, I'd like to start with an analogy. It's like a rubber band. When you stretch a rubber band to an extreme, And typically, we are used to it. When you release it, it comes back to its original shape and size. But actually, it does not recover to its absolute original shape or size. Things will get back. I don't think any of us in industry, at least even in our industry, we don't have any doubts about it. And we've seen early signs as the markets have started opening up. Because it's not like life is going to completely undergo a change. Life will continue. But the way we live our life will probably change. And that's what people are calling it, new normal, post-COVID, whatever the term is. Yes, for example, some things will go back to original, maybe. For example, I've got a much longer hair than what I normally have. I'm not being able to get a haircut. But I'm sure post-COVID, I will go for a haircut and not have a change of mind saying, let me have a ponytail. Apart from those things, there will be an impact. Let's believe this. We've been exposed to new ways of doing things. Okay. So the use of the virtual world is today part of our everyday life. At 9 o'clock, instead of getting into the car, we open the computer. We just go to the next room, open the computer. And after that, life goes on normal. We are still working, probably longer. Most of us would say working when you are working from home. So things will go ahead. So we are pretty positive about the future. There will be challenges, but I think that's the whole thing with everybody. Now we discover new ways of meeting those challenges and get moving forward. So we are pretty optimistic, and it's been exciting discovering new ways also. And imagine a session like this just 2 months back. People would have said, are you mad? Who's going to listen? Who's going to come in? But today, that's the way life goes on.
That's true, Theo. That it's so nice to have a slightly lighthearted way to bring in a sense of reality. And it is positive. What it actually instills is that it is hopeful. Exactly the same thing that Anup says. Market is opening up slowly and steadily. And there is hope. You have the same sentiment to say that it's a situation where we can hopefully look forward to things moving and becoming normal very soon. Mr. Prerak Parmar, what are your views on this subject?
I'm an internal optimist, and I think the impact would be lesser than all what we are imagining. I have been looking at this from my industry very, very carefully. And each and every day is better than the last day. So I think even in the lockdown situation, from total lockdown till here, we have seen every day being better. So I think as the cases are improving, the days are also improving. So my bottom line, top line, everything is getting better on a daily basis. So like Anup was saying, that it started with a 90% drop on whatever occupancy or whatever the metric they'd look at it. We also saw a dip, and then we are getting better on a daily basis. So I think optimist completely. I say Uthiyo is right. No ponytails for anybody. I think everything will be normal pretty soon.
Is there anything about the future you sort of feel will come your way, which is going to aid your business largely because of that?
Now, as you have spoken about my business, I think, will grow at a substantial pace because in any kind of a crisis, people go to the basics of saving more money, longing protection for health, for their belongings and their life. I think this is a major change in psyche. The consumer behavior will tilt to more savings and less spending. And government wants the other way around, but I think the people will be a little more conscious about spending. They will save more money, and they will to insure themselves from all eventualities, belongings, self, health, everything. So I think there will be a search for any kind of insurance. And I've been getting calls from everybody, from every walk of life. Is there a job insurance? So that's. That's a new product. It's there in US. I think in India also it will come eventually. So what if I lose my job and how much I can insure it for. So it's a kind of an it's a very different kind of an psyche that we can see from consumers. So our industry is very hopeful. Even the general insurance industry has grown by 32% in the lockdown. So I think that psyche is really, really playing out.
Wow, what a nice thought to have a job security which can be insured. That's a great news, actually. Amazing. Yeah. Thank you, Prerak. I would like to still feel that social interactions are a big deal. It's a social need for us. So I would like to ask Mr. Manpreet Bindra, how strongly do you feel our future will tilt towards something which can enhance interaction, be it any way, be it actually face-to-face or in some other way? Do you have an idea about that?
So thank you, Nimisha. So we also think in the travel space that we are in, and that's the business that we have been doing. So we purely feel that that has currently our business has revenue zero right now. And we are looking at alternate thinkings right now, how things will look like. And possibly, yes, there will be a change in how things will look as we move ahead. And things will be looked differently. As Uthaya also pitched upon, that there will be a new normal that everyone is talking about. And yes, there would be. And internally, when we went back, we have called this phase as a hibernation mode for us. And we so when we were in a hibernation mode, so we thought that we need to stay positive, first of all. Second is to secure and to take care of the human capital, the first and the foremost thing for us. And that's the asset base that we have. So we have gone in the alternate thinking mode right now, and we have tried to find the ways that can help corporates think how they can execute the MICE movements differently. What are the alternate ways in these testing times? How the hotels can and our partners, the airlines, they can come into the play. How we can bring the new sort of thought process into the whole system, and we can create that. We could be one of the enablers to provide that bubble jump for the corporates to increase their business. That's how MICE has been working in all these MICE closely with all the corporates. How that could be, although there would be different experiences to that, how we can try to take away the friction as much as we can from the system, because technology will bring friction, and it's not going to be the same experience that we when we are interacting face to face. But yes, there would be certain frictions, and how we as an enabler can erase those frictions in between and create those kind of experiences. And in this space right now, we think that technology is going to play a big role for us, and there will be a need of a good technology to help us take the business on a positive note and to move forward as we move ahead. So that's how we've been working on it, Nimisha.
Oh, very well said, Manpreet. That means you do feel that our thought process needs to evolve a little bit, and future does lie with a great deal of technology in store.
Yeah, Nimisha, definitely, as they say that when things stop, then there's a new beginning. And the new beginning starts with an alternate thought process, and that's going to come into the play. And the future is going to be nice for all of us, although it's going to be a long journey for recovery for all of us. But yes, while working on this path to a long recovery, there will be new ways that will be found by all of us, and we're going to explore those paths. And definitely those will give us new horizons and new things to test and get evolved around the business that we've been doing in the old past.
That's very well said, Manpreet. The most tech-savvy person on our panel today is Siddharth. Siddharth Shah, can you tell us how easily can we actually blend a futuristic aspect in the corporate world? Can you tell us your views, please?
Thank you, Nimisha. So, see, like, there's no point of a fear for the MICE as an industry. Yes, we are going through a change, and change is constant. If we all in our own journey from in our personal career, We can see that we have gone through 1, 2, 3, or 5 changes, a peak changes in our career. And this is also a change. The only discomfort is that it has been forced in a very short time. So, and that's why it brings as a, it comes as a discomfort. But what we need to see and how we need to adapt that, yes, we are now entering into a change world. MICE as an industry would continue to do their same fundamental services the way they used to do earlier. They need to see the medium would change, the methods would change, and nothing else. And they need to quickly, in next months or weeks, need to adapt themselves and change the offering and take it to their clients and make the world understand how technology can still cover those fundamental of meeting, our conferences, our incentive meetings or exhibition. So world, good point is like in last 50, 60 days of a lockdown, technology company like us are constantly working and pivoting over our strong foot, how we can bring in new solution for our partners in event industry and a MICE industry. And the work has been done, like a lot of work has been done. You can start seeing news now, nationally, internationally, that some conference, some exhibition is happening virtually and again covering, if not 100, at least 70 to 90% of fundamental when we go to a real exhibition or real conference. So I think if that is happening and as an audience is now very comfortable consuming the content on screen because of the forced change, MICE as an industry, there's no stopping. So they just need to change, adapt with the technology. Interesting things are happening. Your conferences are going virtual. The webinar series are happening. You can, the fundamental is to bring the brand versus the end consumer, bridge the gap between both of them. Yeah, the medium might change. It might not be physical, but yes, you can still cover those fundamental with the virtual world. So yes, no stopping for MICE. Yeah. As Manpreet said, there are like more partners when we cover any meeting or exhibition. There are multiple partners get involved in the process. The role of partner might go up and down. Previously, technology used to play the role in MICE. Today also, they will play a role. The role can go percentage by up and down. Might be a hotel industry, might be become a, in these interim times, would be become less active and technology become more active. But yes, as a core fundamental agencies who are delivering the MICE, they will keep running. They will keep delivering what they are supposed to do before COVID and like post COVID. That is my submission as of.
Great. That's a nice view. Good thing is that with Siddharth, we feel that while all the other panelists were hopeful, but something concrete with technology seems to be in the answer of Siddharth. And I am hopeful. In the past, every time we would go for an event or a conference, the most amazing thing for us to take back would be something to do with technology. And it was very new for us. Today, we've come at a juncture where if that technological greatness is actually taking place, we are actually bracing ourselves in a way. But if it can be constructively used to enhance our businesses, I think that is the way forward. That's very well said, Siddharth.
Thank you.
Well, we all know that innovation and big ideas are actually need of the hour. Virtual reality surely has the power to transport us to a different space and interact virtually in the real world. And while we are immersed in this virtual environment, it's my pleasure to announce that FCM MICE will now be able to give their customers an experience of not just virtual reality, but hybrid reality. Yes, hybrid reality, bringing together the physical and digital world. Isn't it surely the need of the hour? MICE is actually a high-touch experiential business, and hybrid model of conducting MICE events on the virtual platform to 2D and 3D events will give an experience across all touch points. Ladies and gentlemen, after this fabulous discussion by the panelists, please brace yourself with something that will blow your mind. Here's a short video which we will play for you. Can we have the video, please?
You're live on the front end, YouTube.
Wow. The video on the YouTube is simply amazing. And I am absolutely taken in by it. Manpreet, the question is now going to come to you. We are very keen to know more about FCM MICE XR services and features. What is it all about?
So when I shared with all of you that when we were in the, we are still in lockdown, so we went back and we thought that we need to divide this time into two areas. That's the hibernation mode and the awakening mode. And in a hibernation mode, we thought that what new we need to do now, because this the kind of this disease is moving around, things will not change for a longer period of time. And as we all just spoke about, and we realized that technology will be a key enabler for all of us going forward. And then because then we went back and thought that all these years, because we've been doing MICE movements, our corporates know, we know, our partners know, other people who are coming on tour, they all know that it's a very high touch area. A lot of things are required to be demonstrated on ground as per the requirements on that particular day. So how the technology will come into the play, we all know that it will come. So then we thought that then we need to add three areas. One is the tech intelligence that we need to add. We need to add a human intelligence plus the knowledge economy that we all of us have in the MICE space that we all spent our time. How we can bring all these three pillars together and give our experience to our end users, to our corporates. And so we thought that, okay, once we do this, what next? There will be a lot of frictions happening. People will say that I used to get this on tour, this I used to get this way. So we thought that, okay, let's put this on table and let's give a solution in a manner wherein a customer goes back and says that, itna mere ko mila hai, acha hai. Maine itna bhi nahi socha. And that's the area that we were thinking that all our customers will think that, yes, this is what we need, itna aaya hai, and I'm happy with it. So can we do that? And then all these three pillars we have joined together, and we thought that with technology, we will give those high touch service points to the end users for them to still experience the services and experience a bit of MICE along with helping corporates to deliver and to kickstart the demand that they want to, that can help them create those demands from their end partners so that they can kickstart their supply chain and it enables them to move even faster. And we have done, we are still in talks right now. I will not say that we have done. We are still in talks with a few of our corporates around these requirements. And there have been some healthy and very positive feedbacks that we have got from them. So around that, we thought that let's create a platform where we can bring all these things together and give that experience to our customers. Yeah.
Well, that's great.
This is the thought process around it.
Is there a time frame that we can look forward to?
We have exclusively tied up with WebContext, and the platform, as Siddharth also said, is already ready. We are today live on YouTube on one of the platforms that we have. That's the 2D webinars that we are doing it. And there's another platform which is beyond that. That's 3D version of it this platform, which is even more experiential for our end users. So we are already ready. And we are already using it, and we just want to move ahead and keep on moving ahead and try to get some positive feedbacks, or even for that matter, few criticisms also from our customers, so that we can better it off, because we are all traveling on this path for the first time.
Wow, I'm actually feeling empowered by just hearing this, that we are so future ready. You have a product which is in your hands. You're so hopeful. The business is actually reacting positively to you. You are now that confident that you are open to criticism as well, some critical comments also. That's really nice to know. Thanks, Mantri.
Thank you.
Oh, what an amazing perspective we have built today. Well, before we began this webinar, my own thoughts were very different. And in 1 hour straight, I'm now equipped with the most futuristic reality that we can surely rely on, thanks to FCM MICE. I'm sure the viewers of this webinar have a lot of questions to ask to the panelists as well. Well, I guess it's time to start our Q&A session. My first question, which we have received, is what measures will now be taken to ensure safety of the consumers and customers at large business gatherings? Mr. Manpreet, can you give me an answer for this, please?
At our end, we are doing everything possible, starting from creating awareness on what's happening, what measures our partners are taking, because we are an enabler in between. So what we can bring value to our customers are the knowledge or the information how our partners are taking measures from the hotel front, from the airlines, what measures are they taking, and which gives them the confidence that all our partners are right now ready and they're taking all possible precautions, starting from the guidelines of WHO, which has been laid down by them to the hotel partners, the MHAs, the Home Ministry of our country, what guidelines they have laid down. So all those information we are bringing it back to our corporates. Along with that, what consulates are taking as a measure to issue visas or grant visas, what will be the new norms for them? So that's a very that could be interesting to know as we move ahead, how consulates will take decisions on issuing visas, how open are the countries to welcome guests or welcome tourists in the area. So we're going to bring all that to our as an information to our corporates. Along with that, internally also, we are making sure that all our asset base is well intact. They are well taken care of in terms of the hygiene and everything, so that they are ready to service all our clients whenever it's required. And we just want to be there for whatever our corporates need. And till now, just passing on the information that we have.
Oh, that's great, Mantri. But as a rejoinder, I would like to ask Anup, by when do you see travel and stay at hotels come back to normal or the new normal? Also, will the hotels start charging much more to recover the lost revenues?
I'll answer the charge part, I wish, certainly. So I'll tell you what is the current focus for us as an organization. So the current focus for us is on the surveys that we've done with customers and travelers, almost 70% of them have come back saying for them, anyone or any organization which is able to reassure them that they are ready for their safety and, taking care of all hygiene factors will be getting a priority over any other organization or any other product that they were using earlier. So I think creating visible signs of what you are doing is going to be a big differentiator for the consumer before he actually comes into those doors. And I'll just add to what Manpreet said. As long as you are able to reassure the customer and as long as they are working with you and sharing their concerns, we are continuously able to evolve our processes in terms of what we can do. But as a start, what we've done globally is that we've launched the Marriott Cleanliness Council, which has experts from both organizations like the CDC, WHO, with some other partners that we work with very closely. We're going to have people at the hotel who are going to be responsible for the hygiene and safety aspect as well. We are putting new technologies in place. For us, hygiene and cleanliness has always been a very big priority. But looking at the current situation, we've taken it to a completely different level altogether, to a hospital-grade cleaning is what we would say. Which includes, electrostatic technology, which is going to make sure that the environment is clean, both in public areas as well as the rooms are concerned. You're also going to be putting in new cleaning regimens in place, which could also mean that, you know, before, you know, once a guest checks out and the next one checks in, there will be some time lag for the cleaning to be done, just making sure the room is ready for the next guest coming in. Making sure the contact is going to be as less as possible with another human being. So even when you are checking in, you know, things like the mobile check-in is already there. If you're a married Bonvoy customer, you can do a mobile check-in. You don't need to go to the front desk at all. Your mobile becomes your key to get into the room. So we are trying to be propagating to those aspects. So from a technology point of view, we are there, and we're going to be propagating a bit more. There was another question which came in on MICE. Now, as far as meetings are concerned, we are already putting protocols in place at our spaces. One of the key differences that we are doing, that looking at the social distancing, if a space was earlier good for 500 people, getting it down to about 300, doing new setups, and just making sure that these setups are in line with what the government is actually giving us as directions. Also changing the setup for our food that we're going to be serving at MICE. So a lot of these work is happening at the back end. And we are getting prepared for, you know, once Manpreet and his team gets people in, we are getting ready for that situation. And this is happening at a global level. And all these protocols are also measuring up to what is required by the local government as well. So that's how we are getting ready. On the cost aspect, I think the key issue right now is going to be what is going to be the cost of all this. I don't think we're really looking at this, at least as we speak today, because I think it's more important that we are able to build faith with the customer to tell them how we are getting ready and what we are doing for that person to come in. As far as the cost factors are concerned, once, you know, the business starts coming in, we are pretty certain that, you know, if the customer has a choice to go to something which in his or her perception is not that safe compared to something which is more safe, they'll probably opt for the safer option. That's what I would see. And that's how we are looking at business. And I think it's more important that, you know, we take care currently of our customer, our associates who are working for us, and, you know, all the other stakeholders, just to make sure that the business comes back and we are able to, you know, build that faith as we go along where we are currently.
Okay, that's really great. That's really great to know. Siddharth, the next question is coming to you. Can you tell me, will the audience actually have the same level of confidence, engagement, span of attention, which actually can be achieved by virtual events compared to the offline events?
See, the same audience are used to consume the content on screen, and they are familiar with the screen. The form factor of and the core content of the screen has might change. So we are consuming our news, we are consuming our award shows on screen only from years, and we are comfortable with that. Yes, it's quick change, but the way it is, like the whole industry is moving so fast, like this session is being viewed by more than 500 people on YouTube and almost like another set of number on Zoom. So imagine we are sitting in, this is a new stage, and we are sitting in an auditorium of 500 people, which is like huge. So audience is receptive, and they are open for change. They have given a positive sign, and yes, whatever we'll create over the technology would be accepted by the audience.
That's nice. It's very hopeful, and it's nice to hear that people will be accepting, and that the mode and the platform was always there, but we need to sort of step up a little bit more and accept it much more eagerly.
So, Nimisha, I have one question for Siddharth. Siddharth, how do you think, can you just elaborate a bit that, because you know the connectivity of internet is not very good in our country, and how do you think that, how easy it would be for people to use this technology on the bandwidth and all those things?
So, connectivity and the high bandwidth only required on a production front. So people who are sitting at the backstage, they only require a high bandwidth. On a user front and a speaker front, let's say, we are on a simple Zoom call with our 2G or 3G speed coming over our mobile or our Wi-Fi home internet. We are producing and we are giving the input to the virtual studio sitting at our home. And people who are consuming this on YouTube, they are, again, for them, it's another YouTube video. Yes, bandwidth is required at the virtual studio part, but that is not our concern. So virtual studio, like the people who are participating from both the end doesn't require any great bandwidth. All the platforms like has been optimized to work over different bit rates according to the availability. So the technology was always ready. So yes, with the change, it can reach to any tier one, tier two, tier three segment across India and across the world.
Okay. But Manpreet, the question comes back to you. What do you think will countries like Macau, who are visa on arrival and also has not been severely affected by COVID-19, attract MICE business in the immediate future?
I don't know, to be honest to you right now. It could be, all of us don't know, to be honest, because, you know, people are scared today. People are even scared to move out of their houses. So we first need to give confidence to our people that they should feel secure and gain some confidence for coming to office first. And possibly we can always look at Macau, because for us, it's our bread and butter. We would love to take people as soon as possible out of the country for these MICE events. But I don't think that people will be ready for next couple of months at least, because all our businesses are currently hit. We need to get our supply chains back. We need to get our demand back. So that will be a priority for most of us. And also at the same time, give confidence to the users that yes, they can come. It's safe. It's very hygienely maintained. And we need to converse this very, very often with all our customers, with everyone. So definitely, yes, we would love to have people to come fast. But if you ask me, it will take a little while for people to step out because of all these reasons that I shared.
Oh, that's right. That is right. But Uthiya, what do you say? Will this kickstart a vocal for local MICE movement if you had to consider to take your team on a MICE getaway? And would you be considering domestic trips over overseas one for now, that is, to ensure... Okay, groups are Nimisha, smaller and the travel time is also a little lesser.
Okay, Nimisha, look at it this way. I think there's going to be, like I said, it's a stretched rubber band. It will never get back to its original stage. But there will be certain key points we need to be very clear and lay it out on the table. Number one is, I don't see any conference or any of these incentive tours happening in the near future, because like Manpreet said, people are scared to step out of their homes. And believe me, it's not just about reality, about taking the measures, the social distancing and following the norms. It's also perception. I can tell you, we have a lot of our channel partners going on incentive trips. Right from January, we've had to cancel some of the trips, because the moment it started in Southeast Asia, the government was allowing travel, everything, as from an Indian perspective, it had not hit our country. But the mindset was, we don't want to go there. So you don't force dealers to go somewhere. It defeats the whole purpose. That's one. Second is, you're absolutely right. And in fact, there's a term which I've been reading these days, bubble tourism. And there was this case of Australia and New Zealand trying to work out, and then some European countries working out. But I think in India, I don't see suddenly tourism opening up between India and Pakistan or other countries, because already within the country, there are so many options. But the thing is, one has to look at the infrastructure. So one has to consider the infrastructure. One has to connectivity, yes, will not be a problem. Travel time will be low, because it has to be attractive also. See, an incentive tour is supposed to be an incentive, something you look forward to. So it has to be the way, and that's where I think travel agencies, hotels, the entire travel industry has to work together on the infrastructure, what will attract these channel partners or any sort of incentive customers to get to these places. If we can lick that problem, the sooner we lick that problem, I think that's where the market could be headed.
Prerak, what do you say? Do you agree with what Uthiya is saying? Is that what is the sentiment which is established in your industry as well right now? Do you think we will be thinking more?
I don't think so. Even local or Indian travel will start pretty soon, like Uthiya was saying. Even if it is near, because of two, first the law that each company will have their own VCPs and they will not allow the key personnel to travel so far. So I'm not, I will not be allowed to travel even if I want to. So let alone that I will do an incentive trip. And for employees, I'm talking about more employees. It's a great time to meet employees, all incentive trips and shake hands and encourage them, reward them and recognize them. And there, they want to see the management team. They want to see the management team, the shareholders, everybody in action in these trips. And it's a way of creating a bonding with the team. But if the VCP is there and no management team can travel, I think this trip does not have any meanings for us. And we just don't, as in principle, we don't just give trips for fun for employees. It's a reward, recognition and a training. So all these things are key part of our trips. And I don't think so. It's pretty, it's going to start at least for the next 9 to 10 months. It's not going to start. So the only option is that we have to find out something to connect up, to build discretionary efforts with our team. Or unko pagar ke liye sirf kaam karna hai, waise nahi, but they should look forward for doing that one step extra, like they were doing for an incentive trip. And it has to be virtual. So this has to be virtual. It cannot be physical in any manner, in any manner.
Well said. Well said, Prerak. You absolutely right on and very honest about how things are in your industry right now. But you know, one of the biggest things when a MICE getaway happens is everyone looks forward to one thing which is there on the itinerary, which is the gala dinner. And organizing a gala dinner for 500 and 1,000 or such large numbers is a Herculean task for the hotel which is organizing their stay. This question goes back to you, Anup, where you tell me, will you enhance the gala arrangement for dinners with something very different? Are you thinking on those lines or are you going to completely delete that line from the itinerary at all?
No, I think the protocols which are being put in place right now are looking at all these aspects as well, including what to do with the gala dinner and what does gala actually mean? Whether does it mean like a sit down or does it mean, you know, less elaborate but more more kind of variety or a different level altogether? What does it actually mean from a gala? So I don't think I have an answer to it right now to talk about, you know, what the gala is going to look like in the future. But I'll just go back to what Siddharth earlier said, you know, that Siddharth mentioned that there will be an opportunity to do events where there'll be a lot of play with technology. I think that kind of, and also to, you know, what Uttayo and Prerak said, that whatever we are looking at, we are trying to, you know, keep it as minimal as possible. If that is the case, what we are looking at is that in times to come, between, let's say, 3 to about 4 months, if there are events which do happen, those will be like the critical events that you have to have. But you will probably be doing something really at a smaller scale in the same city where you don't have to travel, at a hotel of a choice, which where you have the faith that everything is going to be fine. But you're going to be having people connecting from all across the country on those kind of events. And what we are also doing, like, for example, in Australia, we've actually launched a product which is similar to that, where you probably be do a day meeting, but you also have people, you know, sort of connecting with the rest of the Australian, you know, incentive winners or whatever. So I think those are things which are going to be happening. The other thing that we are also looking at is how do we add value, especially when you're not doing very large events. And if you're doing an online event or a virtual event, how do we add value to, let's say, an incentive winner? How do we add to their experience? Does it, I'm just thinking out loud. Does it make sense that if you're doing an event across the country, you get, let's say, you know, food delivered from our hotels, you know, very decent level of food delivered across the country for your incentive winners as a part of that event, just to change their experience for them? So those are things that we are looking at. So it'll be a combination of virtual, hybrid, whatever you can call it. And how does the hotel add value to those winners in a way that the experience is different? It obviously will not be able, never be able to match up to a live event. There is no two ways about it. But can it add a bit more value? Can it sort of get them a slightly different experience? Is what one would really need to look at. So more to come on the gala dinner part and in terms of what it's going to look like. But I think as partners, you know, whether it's FCM or, you know, corporate partners, I think it'll be good to evaluate how do we continue to add value, continue to keep people motivated and continue to drive those sales. Because as the pie becomes a little smaller for everybody, how do you really drive that business? You know, how do you motivate the guys to go out there and grab that business? You know, and events have always been a part of something like that. And how do we build up an event which is taking you to another level altogether, where people have an experience which probably they may not have had earlier, but it also takes care of some of the other aspects of an event, which is like food is a big, you know, aspect of an event. Setup is a big aspect of an event. Can we do small? Can we do kind of a setup at a hotel and then keep that as a background and then create an event around it? I don't have an answer to it right now, but I guess there are people on this panel who probably be able to answer that question better.
I would like to add up to Anoop. I think, and that's a combined ideation with Manpreet. So when Manpreet said that 2D and 3D environment kind of event wherein a user can enter into a zone and again can go to the exhibition hall, can go to the auditorium. So we were FCM and we were like designing the auditorium and the hall. So Manpreet specifically asked that why can't we make it a Marriott look, because Marriott is our partner. And we still want to give the Marriott feel to the user. So so our hotel would still be virtual. There are certain people who will go physical. People who are attending the show virtually will still feel that they are in a Marriott environment. The content would be exchanged. The context would be exchanged. You can meet people. You can greet people virtually. So that is the kind of virtual option that we are seeing for the interim times ahead. So that is like a... So that is like an addition of how a hotel can still be alive on a virtual platform and still be connected to their audience.
Okay. Well, I think it'll be more of you know, how we ideate about it and what is the kind of solution that we come out with which is going to work for everyone. And I think we need to keep the customer as a big focus in this one, and especially the person who's let's say winner of an incentive. How does he see something like this? Does he believe that it's like really adding value, or what else is he seeing? And what is it, their expectations once you have a product? And then we can probably build around it and see how we can take it forward and how it adds value to everybody. And it's a win-win for everybody.
True enough. I think Siddharth does have a plan in place. So he seems the most hopeful here. He has answers to...
Anisha, with your permission, can I speak something on what Siddharth and Rupert are trying to say? I feel a little... I have a divergent view here. I feel that a gala dinner or a experience of Marriott would be of less importance for the person who is earned the incentive. The question is, how do we keep him as recognized, felt as recognized that he is feeling in Marriott or he's having his gala dinner? And how do we create an experience which is not the same experience? We have to kind of think completely out of box here. Is that how do... There is a need of that incentive earner. I have worked hard. I need to get recognized with my company and my peers and my customers or my family. What are the ways that we can complete these needs of the incentive winner? And if these needs are not catered, either virtual or any of these kind of events that we are planning, there is no point for an corporate or incentive like this. The, like Pepsi was saying, that the competition is water. Here for the company, me and people like Siddharth, the competition is with cash or kind. Am I more motivated with the cash? And I don't want to say, anyway, I'm going to go out to get the cash. Le lo, I need cash right now. So the competition for experience, and the experience has to be higher than cash. The experience is what cash cannot buy. This kind of thing is going to be needed.
That's true, Prerak. In fact, the next question also is a rejoinder to what you have just said. You know, visas, ticketing, inquiries, communication can all be virtually done. it gets done in no time and it's all okay. But what about customers' experience, which gives you that goosebump moment, you know, which every organizer asks the ones who are taking the MICE group on a getaway, what is that one moment that you will give, which will give my people that goosebump moment? So do you think corporates will continue to sort of sell their products online in the way that an experience which can give you a great moment can also be accepted and I will be sold out on it? Do you think, are you also looking for something like that, Prerak?
Yes. In fact, my reason to join this is that to build a consensus with the structure of the industry, the MICE industry, the hotel industry, and various people, the 500 people who are joining us. First of all, my clear point is that in any kind of an incentive, the discretionary effort has to be very high to earn, because the corporates keeps the targets a little higher to earn incentives. So the discretionary effort is needed from a sales guy or a partner or a distributor, employee, whoever you are incentivizing, needs to do a very high discretionary effort to reach that. For that, the options is cash or experience. And that goosebump moment that when he is having a great lunch which he cannot afford, or a trip which he cannot afford personally from his salary and he's getting as an extra benefit, that goosebump moment has to be created in the virtual event or around, and I say bells and whistles, around the virtual event, there has to be so many bells and whistles that goosebump moment is created. And as an example that I would like to give is that if you have earned an incentive, how many people knew and can we do a social outreach automatically, turant, rather than he posting his pictures, reaching the hotel and saying that I won a trip and I am in Hungary, Uzbekistan, wherever we take our employees to. So, and do we create that moment constantly in a jiffy while the events are going on? So, that is going to be more important. Visa, ye sab mil jane wala hai. पहले हम लोग डिसाइड करेंगे कि ले जाना है कि नहीं और दैट्स गोइंग टू बी अ बिगर क्वेश्चन एंड वी विल नीड अ सॉल्यूशन फ्रॉम द एंटायर पैनल द माइस टीम इन पर्टिकुलर टू थिंक इनोवेटिवली बिकॉज द नीड फॉर इंसेंटिव इज नेवर गोइंग टू गो अवे
सो प्रेरक
इंडस्ट्री इज गोइंग टू बी अ टफ वन बिकॉज इट्स डूइंग वेरी वेल राइट नाउ ही इज गोइंग टू बी अ टफ कस्टमर फॉर श्योर यू वर सेइंग समथिंग टू दैट यस
So my product, like, yes, even when we think virtual, we are trying to pick up the core element of the real event and we're trying to achieve the same over virtual. But yes, nothing can replace the physical experience. Netflix can't be replaced with a movie theater experience. So what we are doing, we are trying to find our own Netflix in the industry and we'll try to achieve the same fundamentals. But everyone like you and even if we are from the on a technology front, we still love to see the physical event happening because nothing can bring in that experience. But yeah, in the interim times we are forced, and the need of an hour is that we need to find our own Netflix in the industry so that water keep on flowing.
True that. Uttiyo, what do you say? You always have the real scenario comes out with something which is lighthearted and easy to take. So what's your salvo here?
See, the way I look at it, I was just over the last 1 hour, just look at the number of times we've used the word event. I am sure at a gathering discussing MICE, the word event would not have meaning, not even 10% of the number of times. So I think we need to look at it fundamentally. There are two things. The experience of going to a distant land, a beautiful place, that virtually cannot be sort of replaced. Let's understand that and let's not go around chasing. I cannot recreate Paris, the experience of walking down the Elysee, we can't have it here, okay, on my virtual screen. I can look at pictures and look sort of, but that's never going to be anywhere close. What we are talking about, so that's a different discussion altogether, because travel is not going to happen immediately. Now comes to the need for events or communicating with channel partners, employees. Like Prerak said, that need is very much going to be there. So communicating that need is going to be there. So what is fundamentally happening? A travel agency is today focusing more on events than they ever did before. Events are basically a travel agency. Some would have an event management division, or there would be specialized event managers. Okay. So if we needed to use technology, then the event manager would most likely be speaking to a person like Siddharth rather than Manpreet and his team. But look at it, what is happening. Today, there are new synergies one is talking about. In fact, I love the bit that Anup said. In fact, I thought that was a great idea while there's a conference happening. Can you imagine if, let's say, a hotel chain were to have a tie-up with Zomato, and there you've got your gala dinner delivered by the Zomato guys as and when across the country if there are 100 incentive winners at the same time. And, you know, Netflix or one of these platforms have started watch parties where friends and all get together and watch films. So it's like that. So an event experience, and I'm very sure about it, can be even enhanced virtually. There are lots of possibilities and things. I'll give you a simple example. We do an incentive trip, a gala conference. How many people can you take? 500, 1,000, 1,500, 2,000? You can't take the whole world. We've got over 10,000 dealers. This gives me an opportunity to get all 10,000 of them participating in a conference. That's something on a real scale, meaning the sort of monies we'd have to spend and all would be worth. In terms of technology, using technology, video footage and stuff like that, I can bring alive the whole experience much more. And I'm sure it'll evolve from 2D to 3D, virtual reality, the works, and things like that. So I think the thing is moving in two different directions. One is with the physical travel part. That's a separate stream. And that I don't think anybody has answers. But one thing we know, nothing's happening as far as the network and employees are concerned in the near future. Nobody's going to be traveling. Yes, when it opens up, it will probably first be a local this thing rather than the international one. But then will the local thing be as attractive? Is a trip to Darjeeling going to be the same as Switzerland? We might call it the Switzerland of India and all that. But in reality terms, is the infrastructure there? Is that experience? So that is where all the travel aid trade partners need to come together. That's one part. The second part is the event. So we'll see a lot of travel companies get into the event space. So the competition is not going to be meaning you'll have a, let's say, for example, an FCM competing with a Wizcraft or a DNA Networks or something like that, essentially. So it could be different revenue streams and different ways of looking. Yes, the need is there. And I'm extremely gung-ho about a virtual platform. It gives us advantages which I don't think we ever realized or even thought of. I can really bring alive my proposition, product proposition. I can package it slickly. It can really become a wonderful production at and I'm sure much lesser cost than if we were to replicate it and do it on stage. Look at Filmfare Awards. Today, if you go and see a Filmfare Awards, the lighting on the real event, the camera angles, they overshadow everything else because it's meant for television. It is actually speaking, I've been to these events and seeing it's not half the fun when you're sitting there. The fact that you are there amidst the stars, that's a different feeling. Okay, that's a different, there will be a set of customers who will want that. Yeah, I was at that same place at the same time when an Amitabh Bachchan or Shah Rukh Khan was there. But in terms of the visual spectacle, when you see it on screen, it's out of this world. The colors, lights, the 3D and all, that's what you're going to be able to deliver. That's where people like Siddharth will be much in demand.
Well, Uthio, you know, you said that will it be attractive for people to be taken to Darjeeling? I would say, after lockdown, you take me out of my city, it will be equivalent to do skydiving in New Zealand. So it is very attractive for me, for now at least. But do you think that once things do get a little normal and MICE groups will begin to start trading physically outside of their own cities, you think your industry will need to curb the number of participants of the people who will go on the getaway? Will you be curbing that for some time at least?
See, not curbing. Let's look at it this way. We have to continue our business. Incentives are something which will continue to be used. Okay. So the thing is, travel will not be attractive. If I tell him you achieve this and you're going to get a trip to, whether it's to Darjeeling or to Sydney, he knows he's not going to be traveling now. So it is going to be useless for me to even give that to him as an incentive. It will not work in the near future. So we might need to move away from travel-related things and incentives in the short term. And, you know, Nimisha, your point, yes, today, forget Darjeeling. If somebody said I could go down to Bandra, I'd be most excited. But the thing is, it's not always going to be like this. Na? Tomorrow when the markets open up and life is back to normal, we are going to be saying, oh, Darjeeling, not again. Oh, it's not that exciting. Oh, the hotels are okay, but, you know, I'm not going to get that experience of Switzerland. So we are going to be judging by some of the same standards we were using to judge before. And also, it will be different sets of audiences. Different companies have different sets of dealers. Their profiles are different. So what I was telling you is purely from my understanding of my dealers and their profile. For example, I'll tell you, I've had dealers who tell me they've been to an old man I met just before the lockdown at a meeting. And he was telling me he must be around 70 and one of our really big dealers. So he was telling me he's been to Bangkok, he counted some 27 times from Exide. And he says, but fun, I love going it. I every time it comes up, I love going for whether it's 3 days, 4 days, 5 days, whatever. So that's something which will be there, but you cannot fulfill it now. Let's face it. We can't put curves. Like, see, we'll have to go by following all the rules. And I think Predak mentioned there will be certain company-specific norms and rules, and there will be certain government's regulations and all that. So both will have to come into play. And honestly, one thing, and in fact, as a marketer, I wouldn't even look at using travel as an incentive because I can't tell it. See, I'm not able to, I'm showing him a dream when we all sell dreams, okay? So when we are telling him that you do this, achieve this, and you are going to be going to, let's say, Barcelona, when will I go? The other terms, he knows I do it in a quarter, in 6 months, I will go. There's a definitive time plan. But here the thing is, nobody knows. So that's going to be a little difficult. So I don't think trips will be used too much. At least that's my thing in the near future. But as things get back to normal, they'll again become an important part. But I can tell you, travel is something people love. We individual as human being, I love traveling, and I'm sure all of us would. I have never heard a person who says, I don't love going to new places, new countries, or forget, it's not always international. Even in India, there are lovely places. That's one part. And I've seen channel partners also love traveling. So it is not only the material, gold or consumer durables and stuff like that. Traveling is an experience is great for them. But unfortunately, we'll have to put it on hold for a moment. But I'm sure once things get back to normal, and normal, I mean, not in real life only. It has to be in the mind. They have to feel, the perception has to be, they have to feel confident. That's when things will work out.
That's true, Akhil. Pradakji, what do you say? You think you will, when things become normal, finally, you will curb down the number of people who will be taken on an event, a reward, which is on a MICE getaway? So what is the dream that you will sell to your people when you have to get them to perform very well? What is the incentive that you would give?
If I'm going to give a travel, which I'm really, really not thinking right now, when I start thinking about travel, the curve will be there. I right now for the near at least 12 months time, I don't see a full room full of 1,000 people. I don't see that. I will not be comfortable, and because they would be my employees, I don't want a pandemic in my employees. My whole business will get an issue. So I would rather keep them away from each other. And still I'm very confident that this place, this country, this city, this area is completely free of any kind of a thing. I would not do a congregation. So that is not going to happen, at least in 12 months' time. And I think we all see this curve. There is going to be a stage 2, which is going to be worsened because 1 lakh people, we started from 500, we are at 1 lakh in 45 days. If you rebase 1 lakh to from 500, it is going to be a larger number. And I'm not scaring anybody here, but ye number might cross US pretty soon.
That's right, Peter. Manpreet, actually brings us to you. See, safety is a big concern for everyone. Prerak has been actually saying it every now and then that till the time everybody in his team feels very safe to be sent on an event or a MICE getaway, he is not going to be forcing anybody. That doesn't seem like an incentive for him for right now. So this question is for you, Manpreet. Understanding that we will now have to start to find proper ways to live with COVID-19, maybe for a long time, maybe for a short time. But for you, how will you ensure that your clients are medically fit for traveling? Because there is not really a certification which has come up for COVID-free person as such as of now.
So I agree with what Prerak is saying and what Uttyo has mentioned, because people need to be mentally comfortable and secured whenever they are venturing out for any of these trips. And more than that, it's the responsibility of the MICE player and also from the corporate end to ensure the security of each and every traveler who is traveling with us, because they are traveling one for experience and second trust, because we cannot. So we will have to ensure that these guys, all whosoever is traveling on these incentive trips, are mentally secured. Second, we will definitely like to get some guidelines from WHO, from Ministry of Home Affairs, and so that we can also get prepared. As also picking up from where Anoop also left, hotels are also getting prepared to provide the confidence to the travelers that how much care and hygiene they will be also taking care to ensure that the guest comes to their hotel. And obviously, there would be certain norms that we right now know is social distancing is going to be a key norm along with the hygiene factors. So yes, we would be definitely looking forward to get some guidelines from the WHO, from the countries. Maybe at some time, if travel starts out of India, there will be certain guidelines by the consulates for all the travelers visiting their countries. The only other day, there was an article from the Austrian High Commission wherein they said that every traveler coming to their country there will be a test for that, and there's going to be additional costs around that. There will be some quarantine time for that. We were speaking to the Turkish consulate the other day in one of the webinars. They said that any traveler coming to their country needs to go through certain medical tests that would be there. And at our end also, we are also getting ready in terms of ensuring certain guidelines for all the tour managers. Even if the trips are smaller in size, maybe 20, 30 or 15, that would be any right now. So how our tour managers are following the norms of the hygiene in terms of whether they should have a COVID certified certificate, if at some time if the government comes out with whether there should be sanitizers available at every time, at any time, whether there should be some face masks coming into the play, some if in case we are moving in small coaches for 10 or 15 people, there should be certain seat numbers allotted to each and every traveler who is traveling. And they should be, because all this while we know that people used to get into any bus which is coming there. But when we are ensuring that these norms have to be followed, then there will be a request for all travelers to follow their routine as per the seats that they are traveling. There will be allotted seat numbers given to all the travelers. And these are would be the small things. And there definitely there would be certain, we will come out with certain list of checkpoints where we will go through with all our partners from hotels to restaurants and to car vendors, so that we go through all those check boxes and tick by one by one and give that surety to our clients, to all our corporates, that these are the that we followed internally by us, so that we can give that further confidence to the end traveler and they get some mental comfort from there.
Amazing. You know, dear panelists, I would like to tell you that we are getting so many questions from our viewers right now. And the questions that you are facing, these are being put by viewers real time. So it's come to you. We have the last question, which will go to Siddharth, because I do feel that as the Q&A session went on, people have begun to warm up to the fact that virtual events is definitely going to be in. Now, how big the virtual event will be and how different it will be is something that Siddharth would say. So Siddharth, the question to you from our viewer is that for virtual events, when you're creating something which is equivalent of a reward that is being given on a MICE getaway, you may not actually be needing a hotel premise for that. For creating an experience, you may not require a hotel premise for now. But then you will still be using their logos and their rooms just to create that experience, isn't it? So wouldn't be there a little bit of a royalty charge that the hotel may just want to put so while you're putting that experience together? Anup is smiling, I know that, because I think it's given a new idea. But Siddharth would like to answer this.
I got that question, and trust me, you can't use M of Marriott without their permission. So that is a fact. If you are creating an environment for a hotel, it's just a gamification of that hotel is still there. They are still in front of your head as a marketing effort from hotel side. It will not bring any revenue for that matter, as we can see as of now. But yes, they are in the eyes of their customers. What we are doing wrong and how we are thinking wrong, that we are trying to create the same baby in the mice. Can we use travel? Can we use the hotel same way? Can we do how we can do the gala? No, I think that we need to create a new baby for the industry. Your clients are sitting here, Utpio and Prerak are sitting, and they have clearly told that for 1 year they are not planning for travel. And industry is still thinking how we can bring in travel. So we need to create a new baby, whatever we have in our hand as the ingredient from our kitchen, and cover the fundamentals of MICE and meetings, our conferences and our gatherings. That we need to create new. So what we should stop thinking how we can again cover all the old ingredients and deliver something same. No, that won't be happening even when we are doing virtual. It's a new thing that we need to create. But yes, with technology, with all the ingredients on plate, we can create new. And discomfort is that we have to create new very fast.
That's
really Nimisha, if I can just add something here on a lighter note. If this and the way the virtual thing it develops, instead of Siddharth being worried about royalty, you might have Anup wanting to get his logo into it and paying Siddharth for endorsing it.
Yeah, I'm sure Anup is now bubbling with ideas on to what I can do next.
See, it's like gaming today and EA Sports, virtual football game and all that. Brands are spending millions to have their logos embedded in the game.
Oh, that's
so cool. A lot of new things will open up. We honestly don't know what the way this whole development will. But the good thing is, all of us are thinking about it. And I must say, in the last 2 months, I'm sure 2 months back, none of us even had a minute to spare on this. The fact that 2 months down the line, we are discussing solutions and some of it is ready. There are plans to take it to the next level. I think that's amazing.
That's true. In fact, if I had it my way and I could use every service that our esteemed panelists have today, I'm going to request Manpreet to give me a way to have an experience through FCM MICE XR, which Siddharth will put forward for me. I would have Uthyo's point of view to take it as much as what can come our way. I would be as careful and cautious as Prerak is, but I would request Anoop to allow Siddharth to just take me virtually to JW Marriott, which is one of my favorites in Bombay, and make me sit at the cafe of Bombay Baking Co. And if I could eat that pastry right now, even virtually, it's worth it. It's actually equivalent to a lot of things that would have happened on a normal day.
We'll deliver really? It to you, Nimesha. That's all I can tell you. While you're sitting at home and enjoying it, enjoying the view. And on the royalty part, I think that's a different discussion altogether. Maybe we can take it offline.
I see that Anoop is going to take something very concrete after this discussion. So that you're in for something big coming your way. And this has been such an insightful Q&A actually, because it's begun to make us think so differently on a platform which is possible, a platform which is hybrid, a platform which is going to perform so effectively and can hold the answer for many of our queries in the coming months. I would actually now request our esteemed panelists to let us know how they themselves felt about this webinar. How did you like the questions which came real time from viewers? How did you like the video, which was mind-blowing for me? I had to take a few seconds to actually react to it because it was so different. I had never seen something like this. Anoop, what do you say? How was your experience today?
Well, I think it's, I'd again like to thank the FCM team for putting this through. I think what is really important for us is that we continue talking and we continue exchanging ideas. And it's great to hear from some of the customers talking about what is their thought process. And I think at the end of the day, all of us need to put our brains together to find out solutions and look at something out of the box, something that we may not have thought out in the past, but we need to start thinking about it if you're not really thought about it. That's what I would say. So it's been a good experience, and it's been good interacting with all of you. And I'm hoping that, once we get over with this, we continue to engage with each other, to continue to look at solutions, and we sort of keep you at the center, or your consumer is at the center of all discussions, and see, how we can take this forward. All I would say that, getting ready for the future and adapting, and of course, staying agile is the big game here. Whatever shape and style it might come into. And more importantly, I would say, focus on the things that you can do. There are a few things which you don't have any control on. We can only react to it, but focus on the things that you can do right now, which could be, doing some new product or working with, your partners to deliver something more interesting to what the customers are looking forward to. Collaborate with your partners, very critical. Customer-centric approach is what I would say. And then, of course, stay positive. That's the most critical part. We are a very resilient industry. We've seen a lot, and I think it's only a question of time when you find some new ways of doing things, and sometimes the crisis just gets you in that direction. That's what Siddharth said, and I'll just second that. That sometimes the crisis really helps you to push you in a direction which you may not have thought in earlier, but it's only better for the industry and for everybody. That's what I would say. It's been a great discussion overall.
Thank you so much for such significant answers which came from you, Anoop. And I would like to ask Mr. Uthyo, what do you feel? How did the webinar go? Did you really like exchanging your views with everyone?
It's really been fun and exciting, and I really second the last comment that Anoop made about disruptions are really what brings about that big change and fuels the growth. So I think if we also needed to be shaken up as human beings and people to discover new ways and new things in everyday life and what we do, similarly, I'm sure the travel and the MICE industry will find new avenues, new ways of delivering the experience, redefining what an experience is all about. And we'll all learn to live better, even better in the new normal situation.
That's very true. It's very hopeful, the way you state it. It's very hopeful. It reassures us. And on a cautious note, I would like to ask Mr. Prerak, how has this session been with exchange of ideas between every panelist?
Amazing, Nisha. I'm noting the keywords that I'd like, and I would think more about it. Hybrid reality. How do you use hybrid reality? That's a keyword. I like the idea of the Marriott Council of Cleanliness. I think that's a great idea. And hospital grade cleaning that Marriott is thinking. I think that's going to be very important. And they have just upped the scale on that. And I loved what Siddharth said on VR and what he's thinking to bring virtual into events. So I think thought-provoking. I'm looking for more ideas because the need for incentive, need for discretionary effort, need for human to be recognized is going to be there in every jobs, in every on every employee and every distributor. So I think a little short on getting more ideas. And I hope Manpreet and his team, Siddharth, and comes and pings me on a fantastic idea that they have, which we can use in very near future. And Nimisha, fantastic job done by you in controlling everything.
Oh, thank you for the endorsement, Mr. Perera. Siddharth, I would like to ask you, how do you think the webinar session was for you? Because you seem to be having the most concrete answer to tell us your take on the MICE way forward once the lockdown ends, or if it still continues with some relaxation. You are the one who seems to be having the most concrete solution to it.
Because the reason is because FCMN is like talking and thinking over the change and creating the new from last almost 40 days now continuously. And that's why we can see it through. Reality is like that. This is the industry that we are, and we are trying to find the new. The itinerary would be new, the industry would be same, the objective would be the same, the format of delivery would be new, and we are somewhere, and I believe with the one or two or three deployments and one, let's say next 10, 20 or 30 days, we'll be having a new itinerary, industry would have the new itinerary to serve the purpose of our client, and we'll be flowing the way it used to flow earlier. So good input from like from everyone, from the audience, the questions. So they push us towards the wall to think it and answer where we have missed in our thinking. So yeah, it was amazing with amazing panel.
That's true. Actually, facing real-time questions from viewers is what really gets us to think that this is what the real world is thinking about. As the head of an organization, you may be thinking on a different platform, but this is what the real world wants.
Yes.
And I'm so thankful that today our esteemed panelists who come from such different industries have given their valuable time and they've shared their insights and perspective. They made it so relevant. It is so significant the way they have put it forward because it gives answers to so many people of different industries who've been viewing us today. And they've asked those questions and you've actually answered those. It's been a simply outstanding session even for me. What do you say, Mr. Mantri?
So, Nimisha, first of all, I would like to thank you for stitching this event so very well and ET Panache Travel and Media Wire, because we have a good relationship of almost 5 years now going with you. And that's very nice to have you. Along with that, I totally endorse with Utyo, you have always been a live wire to have conversations with. And there's some always some insightful one-liners that we get from you. It's always nice to hear from you and apply those as well. So thank you very much for that. Prerak, I'd like to catch up with you soon sometime. And we will definitely catch up soon. So thank you, Anoop. You've been also very very insightful about what all precautions, what all new measures that Marriott is taking. Because I personally believe Marriott has been in the forefront for all the incentive preps majorly going from India. And majorly the preference of all the corporates has been Marriott. So thank you very much. And it's very nice to hear from you that what all Marriott will be doing in future as we prepare maybe in distant future for the incentive movements. And for me and personally, if you ask me, it has been nice to hear that that we need to package hybrid technology with hybrid model, because that's how we will be able to appreciate the human assets that we all have and create that bubble of economy of scales as we move around in all our businesses. And we will definitely be taking this back as a key takeaway for us, so that we've been how we bring our knowledge economy in